Welcome to another movie review with the Mighty Crafty. Today, I review Scott Pilgrim versus the World. So, I just saw this movie last night for the first time, and I was like, I'm glad I watched it, because a friend of mine recommended it to me like 2 or 3 years ago. And I'm kind of slow on the whole watching the movies type thing, so after like 2 or 3 years, I'm just like, maybe I should watch that movie the guy recommended. So I watched that movie last night, and it was probably one of the most hilarious movies I've seen in a long time. Not in like theaters, because Guardians of the Galaxy, that was some funny stuff. But like it had its own like funny comic style movie, I guess. Where it's just like the words came out like at the guitar. It'd be like when you play the bass, it'd be like little notes, I guess, like little the D, the Tenacious D came out, not the band, but or the movie, but like the whole like D's like would come out. And whenever someone was excited, it'd be like excite, I'm happy, yay! And I was just like, this is awesome. I haven't seen a movie like this, I don't think ever, like in the comic book style where like the words came out of nowhere and stuff. But I thought it was fun how it was like Scott Pilgrim fighting the seven evil exes. And at the end of the guy was like, it took me all 2 hours to put this whole group together. And you killed me in the whole freaking movie. I was like, I just laughed so hard. And one of the people looked familiar. Like Scott Pilgrim is probably my alter ego in another dimension. He's my Canadian alter ego. I swear, the two of us could, if we ever met, and we'd hold a great conversation about how awkward things are. Like, oh, we should totally make a movie about ourselves. And we just sit in the kitchen room all day, just eating random crab, talking about random food. Like, hey, let's go play some games, man. Be like, okay, man, that sounds cool. It'd be a whole hour and a half of just playing a random game. And be like, you know, we should probably do something. It's like, yeah, you're right. Let's go watch a movie. And then the whole movie is us driving to the movie theater. That would be hilarious. But yeah, the movie was awesome. And I thought the setup was really funny. Had like set up in Toronto, Canada. And the Lee character, the second ex, was hilarious. Like, I'm probably saying everything's gonna be hilarious in this video, but the Lee character was awesome. And the fact that he said, he got out of his way and said, hey, the only thing between us is the 2 minutes. The only between me and the girl is the 2 minutes it's going to take me to defeat you. And Scott Pilgrim says, what? You talking to me? He says, yeah, I'm talking to you. And Scott Pilgrim says, hey, I dare you to go down that little slope thing. He says, I accept that dare because the ladies are watching. So of course, because of the ladies, he has to go down there. And then, of course, he dies, and he gets 2,000 points for killing the second ex. And overall, I just think it's funny how he meets up with the girl, saying, I met you in a dream. Is this awkward? I'm gonna leave for the rest of my life now. She says, it's a good idea. Then the whole next scene, he waits for the UPS package. She comes up and says, he says, hey, let's go on a date. She says, you're too weird. She says, ain't it? That's what makes me so arousing. She says, okay, let's go on a date. And then they kiss, they make out, they do the bed. They go in bed. And then that's the whole premise. Until the Knives comes along and says, I'm actually his girlfriend. And then the whole awkward moment saying, I have to go to the bathroom. Which I would probably do that too. I'd say, I'm not saying I would totally date two people at the same time. I'm just saying, hey. In any awkward moment, I'd say, hey, I gotta go to the bathroom. And I was probably, I actually had to stop the movie a couple times because it was so awkward for me personally. Because I would probably I'd feel awkward in that situation. It's like it's one of those moments where you feel awkward for that person, so you just like, I'm gonna go step out for a couple of minutes and come back when I'm more comfortable. in that moment when he when the girlfriend actually knives kissed him in the lips, and then the other girl, I can't remember her name, but it's like Rosentine, I think, says like kind of does that like eyeball like, hey, you cheating on me? So I'm just kind of like, I literally paused the film for a good maybe 5-10 minutes at least, and I just walked out of the room, grabbed a couple bites to eat. I had lunch or something. I said, I can't do this. I can't handle this awkwardness. So I literally had to leave. I came back and said, okay, I'm good. So I continued watching the movie for a good bit until the part where like he wrote the song. He said, I wrote a song for you. And she says, oh, that's nice. So I paused it then and said, what am I supposed to do? I know, I'll just go to the bathroom. So I go to the bathroom for a good, like, 3 minutes, come back and say, hey, that's fine. But yeah, that, oh man, that movie touched my heart and more. It did. I'm glad I watched it, and I would totally watch it again. I hope they make a sequel to it, because that would definitely be interesting. But that gay guy, I think his name is Wallace, he's an interesting character. And in the first scene, he says, hey, what's up, guys? And then everyone's like, oh my gosh, he's awesome, he's hilarious, because he's that one gay boy in that character, oh my gosh. But overall, I enjoyed the movie, and I totally recommend it. And if it ever came out in theaters, I would totally see it again, because it's that badass. And it's totally worth seeing, and I think it would be interesting to see it in theaters. But that's my review / input on Scott Pilgrim vs. the World. Very interesting, and I will see you guys in the next video I make. Bye.